Welcome to this week's edition of Ridge News. I'm Jayla.
And I'm Donisha.
Have you heard that President Barack Obama came to Louisville to discuss the economy?
Yeah, I did. And actually, a few of us from the recording lab was able to see him.
Recently, the PRP reporting labs had an opportunity to experience a visit from President Obama.
Control tower for Louisville International, the Air National Guard base, of course. You see it as you drive down 65 heading south out of downtown. Up on your right-hand side, you'll see departure from Washington, D.C., and then landing here even more than 3 hours later than scheduled. But again, it's pretty open and see all the technology that is there and what they're doing with high-tech jobs here in Louisville with storage and sharing information. Unbelievable place. It's as some people have said that saw the story, that's one place I'd love to work.
Little red button that says record.
Another amazing thing is that one of our students here at PRP was recently in D.C.
Shout out to Malik Jones. He and two other students from the district represented Jefferson County in the 21st Learning Conference.
It's really great that the students in our district are able to do that, but did you watch the Elite Eight?
Yes, it was a tragedy for us Louisville fans.
Yeah, it was the same for Kentucky, but we still came out with the win.
Well, here's Jalen for more of the bracketology.
Final Four, Duke, Michigan State, Wisconsin, and Kentucky. Here next to me, I have Nick. Nick, you said Michigan State. Nick, you said you had Michigan State beating Duke.
Yes.
But let's take into consideration, it's Coach K's 19th time in the Final Four. Why do you have Michigan State beating Duke?
Well, because I got Denzel Valentine guarding Okafor in the paint, and that's the only way how we're going to stop Duke is to go into the paint and stopping Okafor.
Okafor, some people would say he is the best player in college basketball right now. Why do you disagree with that?
I don't know. I mean, I don't think he is the best player in this country, but to me, I got Karl-Anthony Towns as my pick.
Earlier this week, for everyone that is a University of Louisville fan, Rick Pitino released in a press conference, Montrezl Harrell, Wayne Blackshear, and Terry Rozier will be leaving. Wow. So what do you think about Louisville losing in the Sweet 16?
I mean, even though I'm not a Louisville fan, but I mean, I understand they made it, but they said they're not supposed to go that far in the NCAA. They're supposed to lose in the round 32, but instead they went to the Elite Eight.
Yeah, I would have wished we made it a little farther. But now and into this shirt you have on, I'm not a Kentucky fan, but now and into Kentucky and Wisconsin. Why do you think Kentucky is going to beat Wisconsin?
Okay, well, to me, they got a domination because they're the most talented team in the country. Mm-hmm. Well, we got Willie Cauley-Stein versus Frank Kaminsky and then Sam Decker versus Karl-Anthony Towns. Well, all we have to do for Kentucky is stop Sam Decker from shooting threes. That's the only way is to stop him, is to shoot too many threes. And I think we should stop Frank Kaminsky from dunking all over all the other players and stuff.
Earlier you mentioned Willie Cauley-Stein. Do you think he's going to leave Kentucky or stay next year?
Well, now I don't know about if he's leaving or staying, but what I heard is the NBA might recruit him next year.
A high commodity is the Harrison twins. What do you think about them two?
Well, to me, I think Aaron, what's good about him, he's got the clutch. I mean, because the last year's Final Four when he had the clutch from Wisconsin and from Michigan, and that's how people have been noticing about Kentucky is from the clutch shot of Aaron Harrison.
So you have Duke beating Wisconsin. Final score, what do you see it?
Duke, 70, Wisconsin 72.
Sorry, Duke beating Michigan State. What do you see the final score, 72 still?
Yeah.
Okay, so you see Kentucky 40-0, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll see when they play.
Now, I understand we're doing bracketology, but I'm going to pitch it out to my boy, D. Green, who is on in the hallway with one of the football players, and he's going to tell us a little bit about grind.
What's up, y'all? I'm back again. It's Mr. PRP himself, D. Green, and I'm here today with Monte Robson of the football team. So, Monte, I understand that you play football and stuff, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. And what's your motivation? Like, what's your grind? Grind stands for get ready, it's a new day. So what's your motivation? Like, why do you do what you do?
Well, I do what I do to make my mama, my little sister, and the rest of my brothers happy when they come watch me play. That's it.
And there you go.
I'm Jalen, signing off for Panther Sports. Back to you, Jayla and Donish.
Well, you heard it first. Good luck to all the teams in the Final Four.
With the end of the year approaching, juniors have to start getting serious. To start, the PRP scheduled a college and career day.
Are serious about it, give me your name and leave me your phone number and your email. We're going to have an open house on the 27th. I've talked to your career counselor and the principal.
Also on Tuesday, our advanced English and humanity classes were treated to a performance on Macbeth. Here's another look back at it.
By far, the most intense event was last Friday's mock crash for the seniors. Check it out.
Well, watching the crash out here and watching how the police and the ambulance would respond is actually kind of was a learning experience. But in the gym, whenever they did the little recording of the people that saw the crash, that was crazy. That was pretty crazy. It definitely made me want to think twice whenever I decide to check my phone while I'm driving.
As a society, we need to work together. The only way that we can educate our young people on the dangers of drinking and driving and texting and driving is by doing demonstrations like this. It's our hope that if we can reach even one driver, you know, we can stop them from operating under the influence. By putting on a demonstration like this, we hope to get the word out of the dangers of doing these types of things in order to educate our young people and make it safer in our community.
The phone call really hit me really bad because it happened like pretty much right down the street on Greenwood, and hearing her scream and freak out, it's all real that this could really happen to one of our friends, family members, and loved ones. It just really hit me really hard.
Okay, enough with the serious business.
Yeah, you're right. You know Monday's the start of spring break.
Yes, I know, but I don't know what the weather is like, Billy.
Thanks, guys. Let's look at this week's weather report. Starting off today, looking like a rainy day with a high of 67. This weekend, a little wet with the highs in the 60s and 70s. And sunny skies on Saturday, but chances of rain on Sunday. On to spring break week, sadly looking like chances of thunderstorms most of the week. On the bright side, the temps are rising and finally breaking out of our warm clothes to warm weather. That's all for this weather report. Go Cats, and back to you ladies.
I'm so ready for warm weathers and vacays.
I'm just chilling and maybe visit a few colleges. But what are some other people around PRP getting into?
Okay, I'm here with Jason. What are you gonna do over spring break?
I'm gonna go camping with a bunch of my friends and catch up on my sleep.
That's awesome. I'm here with Alex. What are you doing over this spring break?
I'm going to St. Louis with my best buddy, Joe.
That sounds eventful. I'm here with Brooke. What are you doing over this spring break?
I'm gonna be working on my grind, you know, making that dough.
I'm here with Lytle, and what are you doing over spring break?
Well, first of all, I'm going fishing. Then I'm gonna bring the fish home and then cook the fish. And what do I do with my hands? I'm gonna eat the fish, and then that's all I'm gonna do with the fish.
I'm here with Allie, and what are you gonna do over spring break?
Nothing.
All right, I'm here with Damien and Langston, and what are you guys going to do over spring break?
Soccer.
Shoot, you know me, I'm probably gonna be working.
Well, that's all we have for this week's edition of Ridge News. Don't forget to follow us on prp.ridgenews.blogspot.com and any of our other social media sites. I'm Donisha.
And I'm Jayla. Have a wonderful spring break and be safe.
Do you think about me when you're all alone? The things we used to do and used to be. I could be the one to make you feel that way. I could be the one to set you free. Do you